back, everybody, to RPG Live, Pathfinder. We're going to play some Pathfinder tonight. We've got 3 hours dedicated tonight, so we're excited to make some good headway, some good progress on the adventure. We got everybody here tonight, which is a huge bonus. We like that.
Yay!
And there was much rejoicing.
Yes. Without wasting too much time, I think what we'll do is we're going to jump straight in to a recap of what happened in the last episode. Before we do that, let's make sure that we're getting good sound for you guys. If you can hear our voice as well, just let us know in chat. We need to know.
Team Dustin? Oh, man.
Oh, because he's dreamy. Oh, sure, he's dreamy.
He's the keymaster.
Oh, I did send you the picture of the keys, right?
Yes. Yeah. Yes, I saw those.
Three massive keys.
Massive.
Yeah.
Dunstan, massive keys.
Dunstan thinks he's got massive keys.
Yes.
He's overcompensating.
He is.
Come on.
Yeah, Team Brill. Yeah.
You're loud and clear.
Thank you, Daniel.
All right, we're good.
All right. Both overrated.
Right. No.
because Team Jinjin literally shaking the walls as they walk.
That's right. We don't need a team.
All right, well, our intrepid DM is still getting set up, so while he does that, I'll go through a little bit of a recap from last time. In the last episode, we only had a couple hours to play, but we did somehow manage to get ourselves out of the mysterious
labyrinth of hell
that we were stuck in. We encountered a strange statue that we tried to figure out what it did and what it meant. We really couldn't do that. We got to a point where the ceiling was dropping so alarmingly that we figured it was time to just bail. So that is what we did. We bailed out, ladies and gentlemen. And shortly after that, shortly after getting out of the Institute, we encountered a thug on the streets who we were able to charm and is now going with us to go get some fresh fish, if I remember correctly. We did stop by his shop, or a shop associated with this character, on the way toward the docks. And some things were purchased, I believe.
We sold some crap.
We sold some garbage that we had collected up to that point. I think a couple of swords were sold and some other miscellaneous stuff,
We made off with
some
230
parts.
New lords and some
I think
parts.
We did. Okay. I think we sold some, some of the automaton parts.
Yeah, we sold parts from the automatons. Vril is our accountant. He's saying we came away with a cool what?
230 lords.
230 Ooh. Lords we didn't have before.
Good
so.
Lord. Good lord.
Yes. Well, lords are good lords. So
I didn't realize that was the accountant. So
that's where we're at.
I get to hang on to the 230 lords? Yeah.
Ooh. You have glasses.
Do we really want to make the lawyer, put the lawyer in charge of money?
Too late.
Starts not, yes.
I've got the lord's bag.
Although the alternatives are pretty grim as well.
you don't want me touching any money.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Neil Dunstan's not touching the dude.
I would just buy Pathfinder books all day, so don't give me the money.
Maybe we should put Jerry in charge of money.
Ooh. Possibly.
It's in a little bag.
Yeah.
Perhaps that's a good segue to our Jerry Dice that we started.
Okay. Yes, just so you know, what Tom is showing you there on the Battlemat cam, these are the Jerry Dice. Those of you who are familiar with Couch Warrior TV, Character Crusade podcast, you're familiar with these dice. We've used them before to generate random events and even roll characters. So these dice will be used by Tom if he feels the need to say that Jerry is piping in. For those of you who aren't aware, Jerry is actually a rock that lives in a small bag hanging around Jinjin's neck and tells Jinjin what to do every once in a while.
Maybe
so,
a little bigger, but yeah.
If need be, we'll roll those dice, or Tom will roll those dice, and we'll have to interpret the results in some way. So, anyway, that is where we're at, ladies and gentlemen, so I think we're ready to get started. Right?
We are indeed. Okay. So, the scene is set here. You've just kind of found your way around this shop, and you've cleaned up, you've kind of sold some of the stuff from these dismantled and salvaged parts from these construct characters. You've got a couple hundred extra lords that you didn't have before. You're feeling good about things, and you've kind of got this hangers-on guy that seemed a little shady. You are in the docks, which,
can we get his name?
As you may recall, his name His name is Steven.
Steven.
Yes. Steven looks, you know, he looks a little threadbare, a little thuggy, but as the massive, charming Dunstan over here was able to discover, he's actually just recently become down on his luck and has resorted to some sort of thievery to support his family, but really, deep down, that's just not the life he wants to live, so...
Right. I do think Steven the Threadbare comes across.
Steven the Threadbare, yes. Steven the Threadbare. Yes. So you are all coming out of the shop here with Steven. We have a spare mini for Steven, perhaps? Sure.
There's a whole box of them over there.
Great. Right.
So Jin is going to pick Steven?
Do you have a preference?
Let's see. Steven is a little non-threatening. I wouldn't say he's quite this guy. I would say that he's probably maybe this. Okay, so he's a little spooky. A little spooky with a dagger here, but pay no mind. It's a rubber dagger, and it's just prompts.
Okay.
Steven the Threadbare is coming out of a cosplay.
Yep. Exactly. So you all come out here, and how about a, remind me, who's got the highest perception from all you guys?
I don't know.
I don't know that it's me.
It might be me.
One of you guys has a reasonable perception, if I'm not mistaken.
It might be Jinjin. I'm seeing a...
+5.
+5 there.
Okay. That's not bad.
I have no idea what mine is.
That's not bad.
I'm on my sheet.
All right. What do you got? Okay. Dunstan.
Vril is...
That was a +2. Okay.
Yeah. Dunstan's going to be...
0.
So, yeah, it's Jinjin.
Jinjin.
For sure.
Okay. Jinjin, why don't you roll me a perception roll?
I see.
Yeah,
I see. I can see over.
Yes.
All right.
So that is epic fail. Okay.
Man,
wow.
I just ran into a sign.
Okay.
We got that on camera. Yeah, we do.
Damn.
So as you come out of the store, shopkeep, you notice there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Yeah, or didn't notice.
Thugs.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, I ran into the shop sign.
That are out here. And these guys do not look like Steven the Threadbare. These guys look like seriously badass.
Not
gnarly.
Rubber knife gang.
These are not rubber knives. You notice they're all armed with short swords.
And they got dogs, man.
And
I
they have
do
clearly
dogs.
Done this before. One guy has some kind of weird tattoo on his face, and you know that any tattoo on a face is...
Psycho!
Yeah, he's probably not running the, the local, I don't know, Woodmaker's Guild. So, you're faced right now with 6 mean-looking toughs. You've come out of this, and they clearly have got the jump on you. So before we get in any kind of initiative situation, is there any kind of, would you guys like to perhaps talk to these guys? Because they are slowly kind of eyeing you and they're thumbing their blades as they're walking slowly in your direction. And Steven the Threadbare seems to kind of know what's up and he whispers. He's like, listen, these are these local thugs. They stick around here, they intimidate anyone on their way to the docks. In fact, they make their money by... accosting people coming off the docks and arriving in Newport without knowing that this is not the nicest part of town.
Okay.
So they can go.
Yeah, they can just go away.
Yeah.
I mean, I could try and see if, you know, I could give them the whole, let's go get some
swindle?
Fish stick and shtick and see.
Hey, it worked with Steven.
Steven liked the idea.
Go get a fish stick.
So who's, who seems to be, who's carrying all the money, by the way?
I'm carrying all the money.
Have you guys distributed
it? I'm a little tiny guy at the moment. We haven't had a chance to do that. There's a animal of some sort here that's bigger than I am.
Yeah, let's see here. Okay, so 3 of them take about a step this way, and they're getting a little bit closer, and they're eyeing all of you. And they kind of notice that your purse is a little bit... heavier and bulkier than the rest.
Yeah.
So perhaps you guys would like to. They haven't said anything to you yet, but they're kind of coming up and they're starting to eye you up and down.
The entire group is getting eyeballed here. Unfortunately, this happened only after we got connected with Steven the Threadbare, which worries me.
Yeah.
wondering if Stephen the Threadbear is part of their group.
Stephen the Setter-Upper.
Yeah, and Harlan kind of whispers. She doesn't spend a lot of time in this part of town, but she whispers. She's like, "Hey, we're gonna be in trouble if we have to fight these guys. We gotta do something. We can't."
I think the offer for the fish sticks sounds like a good idea. Dunstan is very charismatic.
Gordon's fisherman.
Yeah.
Do we think Dunstan can give him one little dose of charm while the rest of us try to figure out, do we have an opportunity to back off?
Harlan thinks maybe we can bluff our way out of this.
Okay.
So as you're kind of standing here...
Well, we're not out anything for trying.
This guy comes up and agrees. This one guy finally speaks up and he says, "Hey, what do we got here? You guys new in town?"
"No."
"Well, you look new to me. I haven't seen you here before."
"No, we're just clean."
And this guy pops up and he goes,
"Yeah, I ain't seen you here before."
Well, that's good.
Yeah.
Can I try and bluff them?
You can. Let's, what do we have here for your, bluff scores? You're plus 7. That's a charisma-based roll, so that is going to be pretty solid.
All right.
Let's see if you can do it here.
All right, let's do it.
So you can't get any worse than I did.
Ooh.
10 times better.
I guess.
10 plus 7?
17.
Yeah. 17? So the guy looks you up and down and says, "Hey, I recognize you."
"Really?"
"Yeah."
"From around?"
"You were just here last week, weren't you?"
"At least."
"Wow."
At least.
That's what I thought. And you've suddenly given pause to this guy. And his buddy takes a step back and he goes, "Yeah." And then Harlan says in your ear, she's like, "Look, if we can convince these guys that we're not new in town and that we might be connected, mm-hmm. I think we have a chance of getting out of this."
Okay.
Okay. Do you guys have another, do you have any other diplomacy checks? Let's see. Who's highest in diplomacy?
You're going to have to look through.
That might be Vril, but
might be.
He's got a +7.
I'm pretty sure I don't.
+3.
-1.
-1. So it's Vril.
Vril. All right, Vril, why don't you make a diplomacy check? Because clearly these guys are second-guessing.
Yeah, not good.
9.
So you're a 9 on that. You know, you guys have not had good rolls for about 3 sessions. Session 4, it's just going to be the 20s are just going to start.
Rolling uphill. That's what it is.
You are rolling uphill. Yeah, that is a disadvantage.
I mean, in terms of my bluffing them, I mean, my thought is that, yes, I mean, if I'm able to sort of make him think I'm a local, that's one thing. But the other issue, too, is, I mean, I would like to try and bluff them into the idea that leaving us alone is in their best interest.
Mm-hmm. Well.
So, you know, I guess.
Bring it on, Dornail.
All right. Dornail is basically to say, "Hey, sorry, fellas, you might want to keep your distance. We got a friend here. We're taking him down to the docks, and I'm going to point at the island troll. He's got some nasty, contagious thing going on, and we're stopping in these shops trying to find potions that might heal him. We haven't found anything yet, so we're taking him down to the docks, and we're just gonna, if we can't find anything, we're gonna put him on a boat and push him out into the harbor." It's highly contagious.
So the lead guy here says, it's not the rash, is it?"
"Well, I saw him scratching, but I can't confirm. You want to ask him?"
And you see him visibly shudder. He's like,
I mean, you can smell it.
As soon as you mention that, everyone starts taking a step back and says, "This is bad news." And
oh, Spot, not the wrench.
Stephen the Threadbear kind of gives you a nod. He's like, "Yeah, I think it's working.
Yeah. So I'm gonna just kind of turn to Dunstan Jinjin and kind of stay away from him, but say, "Come on, this direction, you know, like. Come on, let's head down to the docks, you know?"
All right. So, fortunately...
Right down the main thoroughfare, right in the middle of it.
Well, right down the main thoroughfare toward the harbor, where the harbor is, so...
Yeah, which is, as the crow flies, we're going down this way here. So, yeah, well, listen, I think that stellar bluff check did just the trick. So these guys all kind of disperse into the shadows. But you do note, and Stephen the Threadbear reinforces the fact that you are not in a super nice part of town. So the docks typically are the kind of place where, you know, everyone is coming into town and it's super bustling, but there are more thieves and swindlers in this part of town than pretty much any other district in Freeport, simply because if one is going to make a living off the backs of the people that are new in town, it's going to be at the docks that those people are going to come to. So,
so
this is not a good town. So very nice diplomacy check.
Excellent.
All right.
I did something right.
Reach down and scratch.
Although I am thinking that as we're progressing our way down, that it's no longer a good idea for the tiny little guy to be carrying all the money.
That's not a bad idea. I mean, so what you do...
Although the tiny little guy might have the best chance of getting away.
I might, but if I don't, then you guys are going to lose a giant sack of cash.
Oh, we'll go back and get it.
In this part of Harley does mention in this part of town that fresh bags of coins tend to grow legs and suddenly disappear. So it would not be a bad idea to disperse all of your funds.
I think we should divide it up.
Well, let's find it. If it's a quiet place here, we can do that now, or we can step back into the shop and do it.
So the shop and the shop, you kind of got a weird vibe from the shopkeeper. Like, he wasn't quite... He gave you a couple hundred gold for what you got, but there was something a little shady about that guy.
Well, I'm not going to dump out the money and count it right in there.
Okay, so you're gonna move down. Why don't you go ahead and move your guys to wherever you want to take care of that.
Where do you think we should take care of the funds transfer?
Can we get into the docks going that way?
I'm feeling like we shouldn't do it anywhere near here, personally.
Yeah, I agree. I think we get down the road.
We should just suck it up for now and say, next time we're in a neighborhood like this, we aren't going to be in this situation, but it'd be pretty conspicuous for us to go into an alley or, you know, and start, like, you know.
Start rooting around in a girl's bag.
let's head towards the docks and call it good enough.
All right.
All right, so you're going to keep walking. I will add this map here. So you guys are currently heading down. You were at the Institute, and you've been making your way. Yep, you've kind of been making your way down here, kind of skirting the old city, the walls of the old city, because know that due south you can get there, but nothing gets in and out of the old city without... the powers that be knowing exactly.
So we're south of the old city?
Yep, so you're just right around.
Oh, in this area here.
You're just kind of right around here. Yep.
Right.
Yep.
Gotcha.
All right.
Looks an interesting area.
Yeah.
That would be considered the docks. Number two. Seaside Market.
So you are
cutting through the Seaside Market.
You are at the Seaside Market. So you're basically sitting here.
You can get fish sticks. You
could probably find some fish sticks pretty quickly. All right.
Where's the Seaside Market? Can you point at it for me?
Left. Right down there. So the
straight below the old city. Yeah.
Just left of the pit. Just left of the fold there that you had.
Right here?
No, further over. Further over. Just above the little dog leg dock. There's
a dock. There you go. I
got
the dock.
Right there.
Yep.
Right.
Let's see.
We got it.
You guys are right here.
Before we're done, I'll see if I can snap a really good picture of that. We can get one of those.
You know, I wish OBS had a tool that would allow me to draw on the screen, you know, and circle things.
Oh, yeah.
Whatever.
Things with red circles around.
Put in arrows.
And arrows.
Yeah. We could even put in virtual markers for bad guys and stuff on certain.
So this particular area is home to countless small shops and pubs, all catering to the varied tastes and interests of those who brave the seas and reach Freeport. However, only the Seaside Market comes close to reflecting the cosmopolitan nature of the docks. This thriving maritime bazaar is the true crucible of the docks, for it is here that most merchants sell their wares and most travelers make purchases. This might not be a bad place to discreetly disperse your funds.
Well, we should find out whether or not we need anything. Did we get rid of anything while we were crawling through the nine men in?
Yes,
well, healing. I would say let's invest in some healing potions if we can somewhere. Because that was probably the one critical thing that we had that we used up.
Right. We just barely had enough, so.
Maybe a sun rod or two as well, but, you know. So
cool. I still have a couple of sun rods. One sun.
I had three healing potions. potions, and I gave one to Vril and one to Gingin. Yep. I've got one left, so we'll want to
pick up a couple of those
if we can.
I think we've got enough lords to pick up some potions.
I think we do.
Okay, so as you kind of come up on this, you're kind of coming up on this north end here, right as it borders into the gates to the old city.
Yeah.
And it runs, so the market runs down south. Throughout, down right down to the water, through the whole district. It's a very large, vibrant, open-air bazaar. Shoppers can find almost anything they want for a price. Okay. The entire area is crammed full of tents and tables and stalls, all filled to overflowing with merchandise ranging from fresh fish and imported vegetables to live cattle, books, and weaponry of all kinds. Mm. Goods of a magical nature can be found here as well, and spellcasters come from all over the city to acquire strange ingredients for their sorcerous pursuits. Wherever there's such a large amount of unbridled commerce, of course, there are also thieves and con men of all stripes. Of course we saw that coming. It's not the safest place in the city, even in broad daylight, and the watch is notorious for ignoring anything short of an outright brawl in the narrow aisles between the merchants. Yet even with the risk of theft, people come here in droves. The prices here are generally much cheaper than those found elsewhere in the city, and so many people make regular pilgrimage down to the seaside market for household necessities. So essentially what you're seeing here is one of the big gathering spots of the entire mm-hmm. city. So think of a big, bustling market. You probably want to keep your hands on your coin purse, but you're also probably not going to run the risk of too many run-ins like you just had. So
that's good.
Here you are. So on the shopping list are healing potions. Anything else that you're looking for?
Any other gear you can think of that I feel like, well, in the last place we were anyway, it seemed like we had everything we needed for the most part to do that.
What is the current healing potion inventory you guys have?
I got one.
There's only one?
One.
Okay.
Yeah, so that needs to be our major investment, I think, at this point.
So when you start talking about healing potions, there's a Jerry roll.
A Jerry roll?
Yeah.
Mm.
Forest through the trees. Let's see. What do we think? What the hell do we think Jerry's trying to say with that?
A bunch of trees?
Yeah, it's like a forest.
A forest.
With a little path. Like
is there a path?
Yeah, there's a path.
Yep.
Well, I mean...
Go straight up the moon.
Honestly, I feel like Jin's got to enjoy
this. Yeah, I know,
cause, I know. Because Jerry's talking to him.
Yeah, so. No, Jerry doesn't talk to anyone else.
Yeah.
Let's see.
Forgot the Jin.
Are there any?
Jin, what's your wisdom score?
Punch it up.
Let's see.
We got 12.
You're at a 12.
So are there any like tall pointed tents that might look like a pine tree?
No, there are no tents around here, but why don't you roll a wisdom or perception check? You're at a you should be at a plus one.
So
you're at a 10. Why don't you scroll this down a little
perception.
Bit, Stu.
I think I've got a point in that, so.
Yeah, you've
got
to have something.
So plus five.
So what'd you get, a 15?
15 total.
Okay, so Jerry, the message that you're getting from Jerry is that stocking up on some healing potions would probably be a good idea.
Jerry agrees.
Okay, Jerry agrees.
So
right.
I'm going to start right. looking. Now I've got a mission. I'm single-minded. Healing potions.
All right.
So I'm going to start walking.
All right. So you do, with relative ease, you do find, I mean, this is the bazaar where you can pretty much buy anything and anything you want. So you do find a small tent specializing in small arms and some healing potions. The docks are not strangers to adventurers either. So locating some basic healing potions is not a problem.
All right.
So, let's see here. You're looking at 50 gold pieces per, which you might be able to negotiate with. Maybe you won't. You won't know until you try.
I think we should try.
Yeah, might as well.
Vril might be our best negotiator when it comes to haggling.
Possibly, unless he's totally off his game and didn't sleep for weeks and rolls a one.
So
could be.
Hey, it can happen.
It can happen.
What I mean, what would that be? Diplomacy,
yep,
bluffing. So is there something special that we would use for haggling?
Let's have you do a diplomacy check. So you're at a plus 7. I like it.
That's nice.
10.
You're 10. All right, so the price goes to 45. If you're able to negotiate.
45.
And you get down to 45.
Well, it's better than 50.
Can we only negotiate once?
Yeah, you're going to want to have your highest guy want to do that.
Either that or...
try to intimidate him.
Well,
with the little guy.
Certainly try to intimidate. Yes, you can.
That would be my job.
Yep.
No, that's what I'm thinking. Follow up your negotiation with an intimidation, right?
Yeah.
So you'd be like, okay, I guess that's going to, and then Jinjin's like, that's not good enough, who knows?
Yeah, I
but
can do
maybe
that.
A little good cop, bad cop kind of thing.
Why
not?
Right?
45.
Let's have Jinjin give it a little.
You're plus 5? All right,
that's
fine.
Too much.
All right, let's see it.
How's that, Jinjin, or is...
That's...
No.
That's
Jinjin. Yeah, that's
good.
Yeah.
Ooh, 9 plus 4. Or plus 5 is 14.
So the merchant that you're dealing with here is just, he's completely unimpressed. He looks at this little rock around your neck with its painted face and is just kind of like, what is that?
Oh, don't insult Jinjin. Don't insult Jerry.
What is that?
That's bad.
So you went through 2 healing potions or 3 healing potions already?
I had 3,
2.
We used 2. That's,
so we've got 1 left.
One left.
Well, we have
so
to,
we need to
I think
at
we have to
two,
at least get 2.
If not 3.
Yeah.
More is better.
I think we should buy a couple at least. So
I totally agree.
It is what it is.
Well, it is in a little pouch, so.
Mm-hmm. So as you're
get 3 at 45.
As you're kind of negotiating with this merchant here, you notice coming up. Let's see. Actually, let's get back to here. Let's change our map a little bit. You're kind of negotiating in this.
Oops.
Wow.
Area
How's
over
that
here.
A maze of stalls.
Yeah, it is indeed.
A maze of balls.
It's a maze ballsing.
You guys still have Steven with you, by the way. Steven the Threadbare has not left your side.
Well, that's why we can't negotiate properly.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, you did just charm him so well with your massive charisma that he's just not going away. But you do notice...
You got yourself a follower.
I know, right?
Notice walking this
sycophant.
Way...
My very own sycophant.
Small dwarf kind of walking by here. And Steven kind of tugs at your thing and he goes, hey, that's Bruner. That's Bruner.
Bruner?
Bruner Welliston. You don't know who Bruner Welliston is?
No, who's Bruner Welliston?
Why don't you do a knowledge local
He's a
job.
Good singer.
Yep. Who's got knowledge local?
He's a Bruner.
Vril, do you have it?
What's that?
Knowledge local. No, Jinjin has it. Jinjin has knowledge local plus 4.
Yep.
Based on intelligence.
Oh, man. God.
You got to stop throwing the 9 13? Into that little rut there. And
see if Harlan can
says the guy who rolled a 1.
I have knowledge chokel.
And Harlan kind of perks up, and so this guy has now gone up here. And Harlan kind of perks up. He's like, look, man, it's Bruner Wollaston. He is he's a shopkeeper here, but everybody knows that he runs, he's pretty much the biggest underground smuggler in the entire district down here. And...
Hey, well, if Steven the Threadbare knows somebody, and we think that Harlan knows somebody, then maybe we should try to call him over.
You want to call Bruner? Okay.
Do we want to call him over, or do we want to go try to chase him down?
Well, listen, and Harlan says, look, if anyone can give us a deal on potions, it's him, but be careful with this guy. He's very, very dangerous.
Well, maybe I should go.
That's right.
Seems
Mr.
like
this is
the 17 charisma guy. Yeah.
I think that's the best thing for us all. I'll go run after him.
Okay.
Run around the corner.
All right.
Okay, so you come, yep.
With his coat
and your Johnny Depp run.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So just within, you're getting within earshot of him as he's actually about to dip into a small, there's most of these areas around here are nice stalls, but he's actually about to dip into a shop right here.
Oh, Bruder.
Okay. Mr. Bruder. And you hold up there.
You see this small dwarf who is just under 5 feet tall. It looks like he weighs about 250 pounds.
Wow.
Black hair, long, like Captain Lou Albano, rubber bands and beads and whatnot kind of wow. hanging in his beard. And he's got a deep onyx set in an amulet around his chest. And he goes, yes!
Okay.
What is it?
I'm to understand that you are a extremely well thought of purveyor of hard-to-find items.
He kind of looks you up and down. He's like, what exactly are you looking for? And he kind of gives you this look like there might be some double speaking innuendo. Like he gets you.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay.
God, this would be a nightmare of a conversation.
Like gas and flame.
I'm gonna be like,
one word or two.
Potions mostly.
Potions.
Mostly.
And he kind of looks at you, he says, ah, yes. I know.
Yeah.
So you're in the market, are you?
In the market, yes.
Ah, okay, okay.
So to speak.
as it were.
And he kind of looks you up and down. He's like, you alone?
Not exactly. My friends are up around the corner.
Mm.
But we're trying to be, you know, discreet.
And he says, okay.
He's if like, they were with me, it wouldn't be discreet.
Bruno thinks for a second, and he kind of says, okay. He says, why don't you, and he points a couple doors down from where you're at, down here, just a couple blocks this way, and he says, why don't you meet me at my house? I'll be right there.
Great.
So off he kind of trots, and off the map.
Okay. The world's I'm going to look back around the corner where everyone is, like,
okay.
Motion everybody on there.
All right.
Told you.
Too much.
Steven's coming out.
All of a sudden, we're trusting Dunson to go into this unknown person's house, which we can only assume isn't their house.
So as you're... Okay.
How could this possibly...
They pass by the rotating knives.
That stain was there when I moved in.
Okay, so he pointed out you end up going inside this little house, which I actually have a map.
Another map?
I have another map.
Let's try the Kush style. If I can have it.
The who style?
Kush.
So there's a small house in here. God, this is just like getting to be a little much. There we go.
Layers and layers.
Layers.
So much map.
There we go.
Much map. Very RPG.
Okay, so you kind of have no indication about where you're supposed to go and what sliding you're supposed downhill. To do. You're just told by this dwarf to just wait here. So, do you want to take a look around?
Yeah, I'm going to stroll in and start looking around. I mean, he invited me. I'm basically a house guest now, in my mind.
Practically live there.
Basically buddies.
That's the pantry.
So as you get in here, you notice a pretty well-kept shop, or it's actually more of a home than a shop, but clearly there's some kind of business that operates out of here. And you can kind of hear some faint like clinking of glass bottles, and it sounds like there's a couple people. So this room goes up, and the stairs goes down into a small landing area. Yep.
I would go up.
Up here is where you kind of hear some clinking of glass bottles
going up.
So okay.
Going up.
So you head up here and you like almost as if you had like caught them in the act.
Uh-oh.
There are two kind of robed what look like, you know, they're human. The robe, they look a little old, they look a little kind of frail, like they haven't seen the light of day lately.
Okay.
And they kind of look up totally startled, like you totally caught them by surprise. And they're just like, who are you?
What's the haps?
We totally weren't doing what you thought we were doing.
I'm just a customer. I got a meeting here with Bruner.
Bruner, at the second you mentioned the word Bruner, they stop and they kind of look at each other and their blood kind of drains out of their face a bit. Bruner's coming back here?
Well, of course, it's his house, right?
Well, house isn't quite the word I would use to describe it, but this is Bruner's.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep. I'm sure he's on his way back right now.
And they just like, you see both of them just go, oh my god. Like, who are you people? Quick, who are you people?
Just customers with coin. Something we can do to help you?
We know Bruner is snarky.
Yeah.
All right. Who get the highest diplomacy? Is that still you? It probably hasn't changed since the last time we did that.
I'm pretty sure I leveled up.
So diplomacy. I'm gonna make a couple notes here. Diplomacy is
Vril.
Yep.
Bluffing is both Vril and Dunstan, and knowledge local is Jinjin. And I don't know about.
And intimidate would be Jinjin as well.
Yeah, and probably perception is Jinjin too, right?
So let's see if we can do a diplomacy check.
Yeah,
without
perception is Jinjin too.
Food. On paper, it's Jinjin.
Yeah.
All right. Are we ready to do a little diplomacy check here?
Yep. Please do.
Oh,
we did. Whoa, we're off the table.
Hey, that would have been a 20. I think we're going to keep that one.
That's a crit.
What did we get? I ain't never rolled a 20 before.
Roll.
Well, 10.
Worse? Okay. All right,
10
so.
Plus
it's like,
whatever.
It's like diet diplomacy.
So
it's half of awesome.
It's diplomacy.
It's light.
So,
L-I-T-E.
Clearly, your small stature has not intimidated this guy enough, and one of them kind of opens up and he says, look, we've been down here for months. There is Bruner is in charge of an organization that is manufacturing, among other things, poison, and what we're doing here is actually we're extracting poison, and you see this entire, as you kind of come up the room here, there's an entire rack of, like, vials and weird materials.
It's kind
and
of opposite
books.
Of what
and
it, we want.
It's almost like a fantasy, like, crystal meth lab.
Great.
Like, it's pretty nefarious looking, and both of these guys look like they have been working nonstop.
They're tired.
They are tired.
There's blue and there's red, but all of these are green.
They're like, look, Bruner is not someone to be trifled with. This man, this dwarf, has got connections all over the city in the underground here. The deal is, and the watch leave him alone because he does generate enough income that he can pay off the bribes. But there's some pretty evil stuff going on around here, and we recommend you don't get crossed up with Bruner at all.
Yeah, but he's got potions.
Yeah, and you do. Speaking of potions, you do notice that there is an entire there's neatly organized racks and bottles. This is how he makes his legitimate money, is that he's actually a potion and kind of like arcane alchemical supply dealer.
Nice.
I mean, we're just
we're
legitimate customers here to make a semi-legitimate purchase from a mostly somewhat legitimate vendor.
Highly thought of.
Highly thought of and not so highly thought of. So, I don't see what the harm would be in that.
And the two guys are like, look, whatever you're doing, just make it snappy. And I don't recommend that you stick around here long. And right then, you hear Bruner come in, and you hear the door open. Yep. And Bruner's in, and he kind of eyes you up there, and he just goes, what are you two doing out? And these two wizards just go, they completely freak out.
Sweet.
And they just dip back into their workroom, slam the door, and Bruner looks up at
you
with his kind of raised eyebrows.
Oh, here he is.
What are you doing up here?
Waiting.
I see.
We thought this was the ante room.
Yeah, we were looking for the parlor.
Well, and he kind of, you know, he taps the battle axe that's kind of hung around his side. He just kind of taps it lightly. He says, you don't really remember anything that you saw up here, do you?
Not especially, no.
Yeah. Didn't see much up here at all, did you?
No, of course not.
Yeah.
It's unfortunate that this room is empty.
Yeah. All right. Well, came here to do business.
Yeah.
What do you? How can I help?
We're in the market for healing potions, and we're looking for better deals than what we're finding in the marketplace.
Of course you are. Of course you are. What sort of thing are you involved in that you need healing potions for?
Spelunking.
Some of that.
Spelunking.
Some extreme fishing.
Never heard of many people that go spelunking or fishing that needs healing potions.
Not very good ones.
They can be dangerous.
Why don't you roll? Why don't Jinjin do a perception check? Or no, I'm sorry, not perception. We're looking for sense motive.
Sense motive. Okay, well I can.
For Jinjin. Gigi?
Gigi.
Sense motive.
That's French to you.
What plus one.
Plus one.
So
plus
you're
one.
Not super plus good. Who's got plus the who's got the best wisdom? You got it. Definitely. Okay, it looks like plus one it is.
Plus one it is.
Give it up, Ginger.
Right.
No.
Five. Okay.
Wow.
I'm still trying to piece together this that is, I didn't is... see all those bottles up there.
I'm not supposed to see them.
The map of
how do I
roll in?
Look, there's all that. Ow! yeah, no idea. I'm still looking at shiny things.
Alright, fair enough, fair enough. Well, ooh, gentlemen, this is your lucky day.
Ooh,
I have healing potions for sale. 30 gold pieces.
Hmm. 30 gold pieces is a pretty good start. How many healing potions do you have for sale?
10.
I think we need 10.
Probably not.
Hmm.
I mean, there's not 10 of us.
There's not 10 of you.
No. But it's possible that one of us could get hurt more than once.
That is true. That is true.
I mean, that's a reasonable expectation.
Not me, but I can absolutely can see that.
Right. So, do you want to try and negotiate him down from 30? To see if you can get him to drop. I mean, he's opening at 30.
He's opening at 30. I would like to see if he would go down a little bit, but my last attempt at that was...
You did okay. You saved us five.
I saved
more
us five. I think we'll give it one more try. See if we can bring him down a little bit.
All right, let's do a...
Were we at 30 or 35?
30.
So you're at 30.
Let's see if we can bring him down a little bit.
See if you can do another bluff. Bluff check.
Is it bluff or diplomacy?
Well, so...
We do.
Both are plus 7.
You're doing
so.
Some negotiating on price right now as opposed
okay.
to some of the other...
So we add them together, it's 14.
Yeah.
Nice. 6.
Plus
not
7, helpful. 13.
Bruner is standing firm.
He's also got an axe.
He also has an axe.
To grind.
Hopefully not.
Perhaps on your faces. Yes.
Nice.
That's why the other guy needed a face tattoo.
Mm-hmm.
Well, if we can get 3 at 30.
30 is still better than 45.
It is.
Yeah.
It's 15 better.
In fact, you're right.
Very good.
We could pick up 4.
Jerry tell you that?
We can pick up 4 and have one extra than we had before.
Yeah. Yeah. Sounds good.
For 120 gold pieces?
Yeah, frankly, just... Buy whatever you think we need, because I'm starting to get bored.
And I say we're going to pick up 4 potions, and we'll call it a day.
Okay, fair enough. Done. Bruner takes your money, and he kind of eyes you again, and he says, now, friends, and we are friends now, aren't we? You won't say anything about what might or might not have been inside...
Of course not, but we will tell everyone about how great your health potions are.
Gentlemen, I knew it.
It's the Bruner healthcare plan.
He slaps both your back, and he's just got this, these beefy, strong arms, and he slaps you on the back with just enough so you know that this guy is seriously not to be messed with.
Okay.
And he says, I count you now as my friends. Thank you so much.
Excellent.
Now, if you wouldn't mind, I have a few things to attend to.
And so do we.
And he just shoves you out the door. All right, perfect. So you are plus 4.
You tracking that inventory?
There we go.
So what do we got?
You got it.
Well, we're going to pick up 4 health potions.
Yep.
We go down 120 lords. I think that we should divvy up the health potions here.
Sure.
And maybe the remaining coin?
And the remaining coin. Yep.
Okay.
Which seems like a good place to do that.
Yeah. Let's do that. I've got one potion in my inventory already, so we've got four more, right? You bought four?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right.
One apiece.
All right, so you get out of here. Get out of Bruner's. And you're kind of coming back down the alley whence you came. And, Ginger, why don't you do another perception check?
Oh my God. Don't roll it on the map. It's not
yeah, don't roll it on the map.
You gotta roll decent at some point.
15!
Ooh, plus a little what?
What's that based on? Wisdom?
Perception. It's based on wisdom, but you'll have a bonus
5. So you're 20.
You're a plus 5, so you got a 20. Nice. So you notice.
Oh, I get it.
There's no one in the room. Oh.
He figured out what was happening in the place we just left, apparently.
Yeah, that's helpful.
So as you're, you come out of Bruner's and you notice that on the rooftop right over here, there's a spotter. There's like a kind of a shady little figure
right
from the roof, and he's clearly looking at you.
Who am I next to?
So you are, well, where's your guy?
Right here.
See, you're here.
This is...
Let's see, that was Bruner. This is us. This is our friend Steven.
This would be, I think that's Dunstan.
Yeah.
No, that's Dunstan. This is, who's green?
Harlan's green. Harlan's green, yep.
Oh, it is.
So.
Yep. Okay. So you do this little kind of guy who's just kind of tucked right below the roof line, right. Just clearly just spotting right at you.
Okay. Mm. I'll just kind of nudge back and...
To Harlan?
Yeah.
Okay. So she picks up on you and says, okay, kind of nods discreetly.
So, all right. Is he just watching?
Just kind of just staring right down at you guys. Yep.
Okay.
And obviously trying to be inconspicuous about it.
All right. Well,
staring at you, trying to be inconspicuous.
Well, yeah, I'll let
you know. And... Kind of hiding up there, but like, you know.
Clearly you can see
the blaze orange hat that gave him away.
with the jangling bells on it.
All right. How high up are these roofs? Are they like two stories?
Yeah, you're solid 20 feet at least.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
You know, respond to that at all? You want to shout? You want to throw something at him? You want to keep walking?
No, as soon as after I let Harlan know, and hopefully we'll do a little phone call.
Yeah, Harlan kind of whispers then back down the line to Dunstan. He's just, you know, she says, look, there's someone up there. Ginger spotted someone.
So, okay, I'm going to look up there. Want me to shoot him?
That's right, you're armed, aren't you?
Yeah. I'll just like start reaching for the pistol.
Yeah.
And that's great.
I don't care.
All right, so you reach for the pistol.
I was just going to be happy to ignore him, but I don't care either way.
You reach for the pistol, and the face just disappears. Just right below the roof line.
Nice job.
Yeah.
Problem solved. All
right, well, we'll keep making our way to the docks. Eventually, we'll make it there.
You want for I should shoot him. All right.
I don't care.
Whatever. It's up to you.
It's good practice.
Whatever you feel like.
All right. Do any of you guys have profession?
Profession
skills.
Vril does. Yeah. I don't know if anyone else does.
I know. I don't.
We got the
barrister. Oh, that's right. He's the vigilante lawyer.
Yep.
Yeah.
No other professions. The rest of us are basically on the public dole.
Okay.
Public dole. Yeah. Oh, look, open pockets.
Yeah. Okay.
Although I can't swim, apparently. That's a big problem. I sink.
All right, so you're going to start making your way.
Dense.
It occurs to me. I mean, we're traveling around with a barrister. I mean, we should be able to threaten to sue
people.
Yeah,
yeah.
You get them off our case.
That's true.
You know?
To handle.
Although it probably wouldn't have worked.
Handle these social situations a little bit more.
Those thugs, we could have threatened to sue them.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't think that would have worked.
Right. Calling my lawyer. He's right here.
He's right here. Hang on for a minute. I have to write up a writ.
Sign here.
Yep.
Be so nice
your,
you
keep messing with us, we're going to make you sign a bunch of documents in triplicate.
Go serve them.
OK. Okay, so you're all just kind of moving down here, and...
It's hard to walk behind Dunstan. He's sacheting.
He's got no, such
he's
a nice shed.
He struts. He's more like a rooster, I think. Strutting.
Ginger, another perception check.
All right.
Are we getting anywhere?
Yeah.
Like, we're getting there.
Where the hell are we?
13. 5, was it? 18.
18's pretty good.
Okay. So over here, you kind of notice a little dude.
I'm glad he's around.
I know,
because
right?
He's noticing. I think he's...
He's kind of come over this bridge, and you notice things. There's another dude. He's kind of eyeing you guys. He looks similar. Got a kind of a dark hood, similar to this dude that you found.
I was gonna say the dude on the roof.
Yeah, yep.
All right.
They do not look savory.
I'll just I'll keep walking, but I'll just holler out behind me, Dunstan. Think you can hit that one?
Oh sure. I'll pull over the pistol again.
I'll just keep walking.
I'm just huddled in the back.
That one?
Yeah. It's kind of a far shot, isn't it?
Not so bad.
This guy is not. He is just staring you guys down.
Damn, he's calling my bluff.
Yeah.
Depends. Do you want to really bluff?
I don't know. So what's he doing? He's just standing there staring
at us? Yeah, he's kind of like, you know, he's kind of off in the shadows, just kind of like hanging out there. You don't really, can't really get a sense for what
pick
exactly
up the
he's
halfling.
Doing. But he's also... So he's... So he is just kind of sitting there, and he's not moving back, but he's also not really advancing like toward you guys either. Like, he's clearly, like, he's just kind of observing.
Huh. Looks like Vril got replaced by this gentleman.
Oh, here. Yeah. Oh. We don't want,
whatever that
is. Well, if we're,
do we need to head over that way across the...
You're actually going to be walking right along the waterfront.
Oh, so we can just keep going straight.
I say we just let it go. Just keep walking straight, and...
But people seem very keen on watching us closely.
Yeah.
That doesn't make me very comfortable.
We're interesting.
Mm-hmm. We are interesting.
I feel like prior to going to the Institute, we didn't kind of get this kind of attention.
Scrutiny.
Right? Yeah. So let's just be, we'll be on our guard, but I think we should just keep going where we're going.
Yeah. Okay.
Hustle down a little bit, but... So I'm getting a little nervous now. Vril is starting to walk around with his, you know, with his hand on his knife now, so.
Yep, you start to kind of walk by, and as you do, this guy just kind of, like, starts slinking away, moving down. He's not really trying. He knows that he's seen you, but he's really just kind of slinking away.
Which means that we're approaching ground zero, apparently.
Yeah, I'm worried about someone coming from behind us.
Okay, let's...
They came from behind.
And the rooftops as well.
Yeah.
Because, I'm worried about crossbows from the rooftops.
We're totally in an intersection here where we could get ambushed, so...
Yeah. Well, let's keep going. Are there other people around? Is it busy?
Yeah, I mean, it's not like... I mean, this is Freeport, so there's plenty of, you know, regular kind of urban activity going on.
But
people are kind of coming and going.
But someone's standing there staring at you.
Yeah,
it's going to stand out.
Well, it is when you roll a 17 on your perception check.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay.
Exactly.
All right.
Okay. All right, so you're going to keep going?
Keep going.
All right.
For now.
Great.
So we all know that we're being followed or watched at least, so...
That is true.
But
so
there's
you
not
are,
a whole lot we can do about it at the moment.
We're gonna slide you guys off of here.
Back on a little bigger.
Kind of make it towards the.
Do you want the main big map?
Yeah, let's just get that out. So now, you have.
How close are we to the docks? If we
so
got
you're.
Close
yep, there? You're coming up. You're just right about getting right down here. Now you're gonna have a fairly.
Yeah, we gotta get all the way to 23. I don't know exactly.
You're gonna have it pretty far down. So yeah, you don't. You all realize that you don't know exactly where Pier 23 is.
And all of a sudden, it seemed like a really long way away.
So they are all piers, but you don't really know where you're going.
6 or 9. Anyway, it's down that way. You know that.
Okay.
It's either the mouth of hell or fish stew.
I prefer fish stew.
Someone say stew. What?
No.
Okay. So you're going to start making your way down.
If we've gotten to the docks, yeah, we might as well just follow the docks.
Yep. Okay.
Boardwalk.
So as you're coming down a little bit closer.
God, I can't believe how shiny the city is.
I know.
It's so
just
clean.
Brand
city.
New.
Shiny.
It's waxy is the problem.
We'll all kind of come
shiny.
Up.
Wax on.
And this is really kind of the edge of where Freeport's settled and built up, and everything around here looks kind of ruined and run down and dilapidated. It's still the city, but you're clearly on some kind of outskirts. And there are a couple people kind of milling around. We've got some kind of Indian tavern
kung
here.
Fu
yeah, moves. Some dude is doing kung fu in the doorway.
Just as morning tai chi.
He's
trying to loosen
cool
up.
Cool, kind of coming out here. I mean, there's people around.
Okay.
There's people around. No one looks like they've had a bath in a few days.
I don't see any problem with that.
Yeah.
Had a bath since last time I fell overboard.
Yeah. So here you are. You're
That's
kind of at the
awesome.
at the edge of the known. Is roughly where you think the pier might be. But you really have no idea.
Okay, maybe I'll find someone to ask. Someone who looks like somewhat non-threatening.
Okay.
The smellier the better, or
the smellier the better. We kind of have you guys
follow your nose.